Hey, what's going on, guys? Matt back here with another tutorial, and today we're going to be looking at fonts using variables. So what I've got in the scene is just a cube there, and I've got two other objects. One of them's got a 5 that shows through the object, and the other one's got the number 5 that shows from behind the objects. You can rotate around it. Obviously, they go backwards if you go behind them. So just to explain the first one, the one that you can see through objects, it's a lot easier to actually create. So all you want to do is create an empty game object and then add a text mesh by going add component mesh text mesh. And then that adds it here. And the only things I've changed here is I've changed the font size to 50. And then by doing that, I've then scaled the object down. And what that allows you to do is have a much higher detailed like text when you scale it up. I've set the font to Arial, this Arial here. And then I've set the color to black just so I can actually see it. And one other thing you might find useful is setting these to center, middle center and center here as well. So you can actually make it so everything comes from the center of it. So, and then there's just a little bit of code that goes with it, which is just a variable of my info, which I've got set to anything at the moment. You can have it to a string or an integer or a float or whatever, because you convert it to a string to be able to use it as the text. And then inside the update function, so whenever this is changed, it will actually update instantly. We've got our transform.getComponent text mesh with a capital T, capital M, so you can actually access the component. .text equals two inverted commas and then plus my info. So it's literally just converting that 5 into a string. And then back in here, that then shows the one that we can see through everything. And that's because the way it works is almost like GUI text, apart from it has a position in the world based on the position of this object here. And then the second one we've got is a little bit more difficult. We've got to create our own shader and a material that goes along with that, and we also have to import a font. Now, to import the font, you just want to type font down here. I'm not sure how you can do it on a Mac, but all you got to do is basically get the font files, drag them on, and you'll be left with these. You get all versions of the font as well, so you get the bold versions and everything if you wanted to use those. And then we also we create a shader by going create and shader, and all this is for is so we don't see it through objects. And if I can open up that, I'm not going to go to too much detail. Honestly, I don't know the shader code too well. Basically, you pretty much need this bit here. But the rest of it's all to make it so it works a bit better as well. So if I close that off, just close them. And then we create a material by going create material there. And then that material, I've just named everything 3D text, just so it's text is in 3D space. And then inside that material, you can drop down the shader and go custom and then 3D text, which is the one I named here. And then inside that, we can choose our texture there. And what I chose was the font texture from here, and you drag it over onto that. And then I also set the color to black just because I could see it through things. So I could see it on like against the white background. The next thing I did was create another empty object. And inside that empty object, I did exactly the same stuff. Apart from I also dragged a material onto it. And then if that does reset, just set everything the same way we had it before. And the final thing to do is to set this this font to the font that we actually dragged in as opposed to the default one. So you want to use the one that's actually in capital letters there, but and then that is pretty much it. Make sure you set that first and then add the material, where else it does this and you won't be able to see, you'll be able to see through just like that. So if we then drag our shader material over to here, it drags everything we wanted over with it. We can hit play and then you can't see it, you can go around. One last thing, you can change this variable during the game via the code, or obviously you could change it before the game. Just open it up and you can set it by going into the text script and say, I don't know if I wanted to set it to, say, shoes. I can save that. I can reset my script so it has it with it. And if I hit play, it'll say shoes. And obviously you can only see the bits that are, would be visible by the camera anyway. So I hope that's been useful. I'm currently working on a series that this will be very useful for inside it, and it's going to be creating a game from pretty much from start to finish, or getting it to a stage where we can develop on it further. So that's what I've been working on. Hopefully there'll be a nice long series on that very shortly, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.